Hello everybody, today I will talk about Rosa's question, and this is on the CPA test and need to learn how to do Rosa's question in a course accounting. So I will begin the first one. In here, Rosa's cost is mean we distribute the department. They go flow from landing, filling, and packaging. This is process costing. It means one product will go one department, they will move another location, and they just continuous and similar. Then they should be similar products. This one used for the mass production. For example, this is about process costing in a different location. For example, Coca-Cola and Pepsi. They just produce only one soda, and they will go through different departments like baking soda, sugar, mixing, something like that, and similar other units in here. In here, I will make the distinguish between drop order cost and process cost. About drop order cost, cost assigned to each job and product have unique characteristic. For example, I will draw for you. This means when you produce one product, they will distribute different job like that. For example, I create the jeans. We have the blue jeans, the pink, and the dark. It means that when we do drop order cost, they will create different type of product in different color. That's about drop order cost. About process cost, it means we have series of connected manufacturing process of department. For example, I make a pizza. I need to have about mixing, just like sugar, powder, vegetable, then I go baking. This means that they will go through the series. We cannot jump one dessert to over there. They should go in one by one. That's about process cost. And this is very simple example how to understand about process cost and drop order cost. In here, that's about information between drop order cost should be in here, and process cost should be in this one. That's why I just mentioned in here. And here is similarity and difference. Similarity on drop order costing and process cost is mean they have a manufacturing cost. They always use direct material, direct labor, and factory overhead. They flow of cost. It mean when we purchase the raw material and we use this material, they will flow the cost to another the account. I will show at later. And different, they have number of work in different, document in different, boy in cost are total in different too. Unit score of computation different for each department. Here, let's see about the seemly way to understand what's about the different in here. You see that the number in different. Total manufacturing cost, it means we divide own equivalent unit when we convert them, and cos each drop is mean we have the base and we have cos different drop, and we divide to get the percentage to distribute the cost in each work in process in drop number. So today I will teach you about how to do about journal entry of process cost flow, and here in the basic here is a good example about the ice cream, and it just show you how to do about the process cost in the ice cream between the mixing and the packaging. So this is the T account today I will provide in the process costing. First, we have the material, we have purchase, and in here we will use two type of material. Direct material, direct material will go to work in process. Direct material, then we go to the factory overhead. You can see that direct material will go through in the work in process, and indirect material, then we go to factory overhead. Later that, after we have factory overhead, they will put in the debit side factory overhead incur and factory overhead incur in here in this side. Later that, we will distribute the factory overhead in here. If they begin to do the process, after we have direct material, direct labor, and factory overhead, we can sum this the first department in here first. We will sum out three distinct together to get the total work in process available for use. After we finish the product, then we transfer the cost work in process to in here, because we just move the product from mixing department to the bucket department, so that we have the total in here. Later that, we sum 14 together. We have work in process available for you in the bucket department. And if they want to finish good, we can transfer the cost of manufacturing cost in here. After we want to sell the product, we transfer cost of goods sold in here. So that is the flow of the cost. We need to learn how to do about process costing. In here, I will have some example. Purchase material on account 88,000. We can see that. This is about the material. This is accounts payable. Accounts payable is mean we have still all of our material from the supplier, and we will pay back before. The next one, this is about direct material and indirect material. For direct material, they should be go to work in process. Indirect material, they will go to the factory overhead. You can see that $81,125, they will distribute work in process in mixing and packaging and factory overhead mixing and packaging. So we have shooting. This is direct material. This one is for indirect material. So that we have two things we need to distribute in here. A and B, that is the basic one to do about materials. The next one, this is labor. In labor, we have direct labor. They should be go to work in process, because everything related to direct material, direct labor, they should go to work in process. The next one, that's about depreciation of the machine. Depreciation not related to direct material, direct labor, they should go to factory overhead. And we know that factory overhead, let's see about indirect. So we have the journal entry like this, because factory overhead is mean they affected on the whole company. So the equipment they affect in the whole company. Next one, they will provide for you. After they begin do missing a packaging, this means this factory overhead will move to work in process, because in here, factory overhead, let's see on the debit side, we can see that. Let's see when they ready to go working, they will move to the factory overhead in the work in process in here. So that's it, they begin to work. And this is why we have the this journal entry. This one we transfer from working process of the missing to the working process of the packing. This is this one. You see that? They transfer cost of unit of transfer out to the packaging department. Why? Because they just finished the product in the missing the department, so they just move the cost to the work in process packing department so that they can continue to do. The next one, let's see, transfer the goods. This means after we finish doing produce, we just move to inventory. Let's see about finished good aspirin inventory like this. Here, let's see the finished good, and we need to put in the aspirin inventory so that we can store the aspirin after finishing producing. And the last one, that's about cost of goods sold. That is so the basic one. When the customer want to purchase the product in the inventory, so that we transfer finished goods go to cost of goods sold. And this is the last one in here. You know that on the journal entry, and in here that just have the flow of the cost, and we need to know that everything. And ending inventory, that's the ending balance, and we just calculate at the end, and we have the total inventory in here. So that's the end of my video today. Thank you for watching.